bit.
Right ahead of Secretary of State Hillary Clinton gearing up to testify before the House Select Committee on Benghazi. That's happening on Thursday. Joining us right now is Brad Blakeman. He is former deputy assistant to President George W. Bush. Good to see you, Brad. Thanks so much for joining
Good morning.
Us.
Thanks.
Yeah, it's funny to see a little levity yeah. going into this this testimony. That was pretty hilarious on SNL. What are you expecting Thursday?
Well, I think Trey Gowdy has got some new evidence to produce. And what it seems to be is that they had warnings in Benghazi that Benghazi was likely the place for unrest to happen if, in fact, the Gaddafis could not be dealt with. Apparently, Obama chose not to negotiate with the family. They warned of violence, and they also picked the place of violence, Benghazi. That's where it happened. And it all goes to the narrative that Benghazi happened because America was not prepared. We sent our ambassador in to a consulate that should never have been used as one. It was lacked security. It lacked hardening. So the narrative that was given at the time was that somehow the intelligence didn't match the times, and we know that's just not true. And also, a video was not responsible for that attack.
Right, but do you think this sentiment, or what you're suggesting, is actually going to be the sentiment around the hearing, or are we going to be looking at this and questioning the credibility of the committee, given what Kevin McCarthy said about its goal to take Hillary Clinton's numbers down?
Well, unfortunately, the credibility has been attacked. That's a fact. McCarthy spoke and misspoke badly about the intent of the committee.
Right.
That was never the intent of the committee. So, yes, no matter what comes out of this committee, it's going to be tainted by what McCarthy said, and that's unfortunate.
Yeah. Anthony Scaramucci?
No, Brad, I guess what I'm more concerned about is what are the procedures going to be going forward to protect our diplomats in these areas? I think
exactly.
Ultimately, at the end of the day, isn't that what the committee's real goal is? And so what do you think about that?
I think the findings have already been acted upon, actually. I think in the last 2 years since the attack, we've learned a lot about security and force protection of our embassies, our consulates, and other government assets. So I think that's already underway, and that's the good thing that's come out of this committee so far.
What do you make about Joe Biden right now? I mean, the vice president continuing to consider, is he leaning toward the presidential bid? What do you think it means for this race if he, in fact, enters?
Well, look, if Joe Biden was watching the debate, there's no reason why, if I were Joe Biden, not to enter. Because, look, there's not much competition. As a matter of fact, it looked like in some points of the debate that it was an endorsement of Hillary Clinton, especially when Bernie said, well, I don't give a damn about your emails anymore. So Joe Biden would set this race on its ear. It would not make Hillary the anointed selection for the party. Hmm. And by the way, it's also a hedge against Hillary being indicted, because this FBI is a criminal investigation and she could face indictment by this Justice Department.
Would he really indict her, though? I mean, isn't that the point of the Democrat debate, that they're all, having fun with each other? They're now on SNL. You know, it's a big joke. At the end of the day, they're getting paid by each other. You know, will he actually go after Hillary Clinton?
He would have to in order to win the nomination. But Hillary is weakened. The FBI is nonpartisan. They're not political.
Yeah.
The Justice Department may be. But Comey is a tough director of the FBI. And you saw when the president misspoke and said there's nothing there, and Comey's people came right out and started leaking. There's a lot here, and we're not done yet. Now, it doesn't mean she's going to be indicted, but the fact that she's under criminal investigation is an opportunity for Joe Biden to come in.
But would he go after her like a Republican would, is my question.
He would have to. He would have to in order to secure the nomination of his party. And that's exactly what primary systems are about, is selecting a Democrat, which means that you have to put yourself in a position to attack the other in order to succeed.
Yeah, it's good analysis, Brad. Thanks so much for joining us. We appreciate your time this morning. We'll
Pleasure.
See you soon. Take a-